that you must be in an attitude of prayer. If you don't want Satan to catch you unprepared, be in an attitude of prayer. Let your divine nature in. The divine nature we talk about, we that are people of God, we have divine holiness. While people of Satan, they have divine what? Nature of Satan. So they too operate by divine nature. But our is divine holiness. They are divine nature of Satan to kill, to destroy. But our is divine nature, divine holiness. So take note, your divine nature must always be in an attitude of prayer. Prayer is the key.
Prayer is the master key. Jesus answered with prayer and ended with prayer.
Possessed by demon, some are possessed by demon and kill people, some are possessed by demon and demon can use their temple to do anything. He will sleep with them, he will do everything with them, he will eat with them, do everything. He can use their body to go and destroy other people, and the other people will be thinking that they are the one that destroyed, but that is not the one. Many will say, I saw you in a dream, you come with the cutlass, come to attack me. Some will call you witch. You are not a witch, but they are using your temple, your body, to do this job. In your heart, many things cross your mind. My prayer will not answer. Doubt. A lot of things keep crossing your mind. When it is time to pray, you remember the one you prayed last week? No answer. Why should I suffer myself again? Then you are possessed by demon. So we shouldn't allow demon at all. At all. You shouldn't allow demon. If your divine nature is busy, meditating, praying, no room for demon. Thank you. Your body can be there, your divine nature is supposed not to be there. You are busy praying in the spirit. Yes, this is wonderful congregation. I'm happy now. I can see fire everywhere. I can see fire. Hallelujah, everywhere, 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 everywhere. Please tell your neighbor, continue. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Again and again. Yes, continue. 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 When we come back, I will put more light. I will want to tell you the dividend. The life you are supposed to be enjoying before now, you have not been enjoying. Your miracle is supposed to be permanent. Your blessing is supposed to be permanent. You are supposed to know that God hears you when you pray. Whether he asks you to wait, when you ask for bread, you're supposed to know. Whether he gave you, will give you, you're supposed to know. Whether you're supposed to ask for bread, you're supposed to know. These are the things you're supposed to know. But you don't know anything, you just continue praying. Continue praying. If you are not given what you ask for, you continue lamenting. That led many to witch doctor, abandon church. So these are the things. So now, what you are just, this is Christian by the Holy Ghost. Now you are baptized with the Holy Ghost. Lights up. You are baptized today. If you are once baptized and you are not saved, the dividend of that baptism, I'm telling you today, it's an experience. I want you to wave your hand. It's an experience. Now you are a Christian indeed. Say, I'm a Christian indeed. So right now, give thanks to God. Give thanks to God for your life today. For your life today. You know, last vigil, I told you that the Lord asked me to commit you to God. Who is able to make you strong and steady in the Lord? You have been committed to God. So thank you, you may be seated. Thank you. So right now we want to attend to the sick one, and that will be very, very brief. Now you are now guest ready to experience the prophetic ministration. Fasting this, 3 days, that is it. 6 o'clock we pray, 7 o'clock we pray. That is conventional. It's conventional. That cannot move mountain. The prayer that moves mountain is when it becomes part of you, the spiritual one, your divine nature. It is normal we shout. The wise men will come out now to pray for people. Don't think that they just start praying, man. They have been praying. They are in the attitude of prayer. They just want to release what is deposited in their body. They want to release. And before they get to you, you're supposed to have been praying in the spirit. That is where you can be connected. But you are waiting till they touch you before you say amen. No, they were supposed to meet you in the praying. That is when you can break that yoke finally. So when you continue this, by the time they come and begin to spread their hand, you begin to see those things that are not supposed to be part of you fly away. Even before they get to you, God will show you their hands. What is in their hand that they use to touch people? You see it yourself. Say, ah, this. You'll be running after them. You want them to touch you. So please, my brother, right now, drop your thanksgiving and say thank you, Lord. If there's anyone that wants to rededicate himself, or you have not known the Lord, say after me, Lord Jesus.
Seigneur Jésus.
I'm a sinner.
Je suis un pécheur.
Come into my heart.
Viens dans mon cœur.
Wash me with your precious blood.
Lave-moi dans ton sang précieux.
Save my soul today.
Sauve mon âme aujourd'hui.
My Savior.
Mon Sauveur.
My Redeemer.
Mon Rédempteur.
My Deliverer.
Mon Libérateur.
Thank you.
Merci.
Jesus Christ.
Seigneur Jésus.
For salvation.
Pour le salut.
Amen. Emmanuel. Yes, God is with you.
¿Quién encuentra en nosotros?
While we are saying this, whatever you confess now, while you are confessing, you also, the prayer in the spirit will continue. That will not stop you. Right now, you should be in this attitude of prayer. It's a normal life. You shouldn't have break. A break in prayer is a break in Christ Jesus. Tell your neighbor, a break in prayer is break with Christ. So when you break your prayer, you break with Christ. What kind of prayer? It is not the one the human nature pray offer. It is the prayer in the spirit. Can you say you have been breaking with Jesus Christ for long? You break, you connect, you spirit. Can you say you have been breaking with Jesus Christ for long? You break, you connect, you break, you connect, you break, you connect, you break, you connect, you break, you connect. Anytime you pray, you connect. Break, you are not supposed to, and Satan know when you are break, and when you break, that is when he strike. He touch you, he strike you. He know he will study you when you are not in an attitude of prayer, when you are not connected, when you are not there. He know that is when he will come to your life. and trying to destroy. But when you know that you are connected permanently, there is no stop. You will thereby never try. Hallelujah. You may be seated, you may be seated. You may be seated. You may be seated. You may be seated.
Comme l'homme de Dieu l'a dit, demeurez dans.
Your divine nature will remain dormant. And when it's dormant, means if anything comes, and if you don't confess, we cannot place you. If you don't, you just look at me, I cannot place you. You need money from me, you just come to me and be looking at me, I will not be able to place you. I can only place you when you confess, sir, this, I will place you. You go to emergency for healing because you meet the people in charge. I'm sick. I have headache. I want to go to emergency. But if you don't talk and you're just moving around, they will not call you and say, you need to go to emergency. No, 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 no. You have to confess. If you don't confess, we cannot place you. So your spirit man, that is your spirit, your divine nature is dormant. You know, when I say something dormant, unact, it's not active. So it is time this year, you must learn how to pray in the spirit. It is not your human nature. The child you chat all the time when you have problem, it is your human nature that shouts, not your divine nature. Your divine nature is supposed to be in an attitude of prayer. It is not when you have difficulty you shout. When you have difficulty and shout that name, it is your human nature that shouts and it cannot save you. If I'm talking to you, let us see your hand. This is the difficulty people are facing today. Like you are sitting down now, now I said it, you started praying. You used to forgetting yourself. I said it now, you are starting praying now. And when your spiritual man, that is your divine nature, is praying, your lips will not move. Nobody will know that you are praying. If people know you are praying, mean your human nature is the one praying. Because it will not affect the body. It will not affect the lips. And your body, it will not affect it. It is the one inside you that offer the prayer. And it will not engage you in strength, power, or you need to stop before saying it. There is nothing like that. That you need to, I need to stop. Silent before talk, before praying the spirit. No, no, no. That does not affect. He can do million things at the same time. He can speak million things. He can speak to million people at the same time. That is your human, your divine nature. You have two natures in one person. But your divine nature has been dormant. It is your human nature that is engaged in encounter, in battle. This is why you fail. This is why you are not effective at all. When you are inside the vehicle and the vehicle is about to have accident, Jesus! It is not your human, your divine nature that child. Because you have not been ministered this in the spirit. It is your human that child. So therefore, that will not save you. If you are in the house and the robber came with the gun. Are you ministering that name in the spirit before they enter your home? No. If you have not said this in the spirit and they enter your home with God, if you chant that name, you will not be able to chant that name in the face of God. Because the more you chant that name, the more they attack you immediately. So now, right now, as we are talking now, start. As you are looking at me, start it. That will enable you to go where Jesus wanted you to go. You will find yourself where Jesus is welcome at all times. you will not find yourself engaged in blasphemy or unnecessary discussion. When you are praying in the spirit, if people are talking, condemning or say all sorts of things, you will not want to be there because you are busy. You are always busy in yourself, in you. You will not have time for rubbish. And you have vision all the time, dream upon dream. The reason why you are not dreaming and you don't understand your dream is because your spirit man is dormant. Charge it. Tell your neighbor, charge it. You can start it now. If you have started, let me see your hand. Let me see your hand if you have started now. Rise up, and give honor to this moment. Greater honor, because you have discovered the secret. This is the greatest secret you have never. For the first time, you are discovering it. New year, this is the gift. I'm here now. The Lord said I should give you, right? And let me see your hand if you have started now. The meditation. And your lips should not move. Nobody should know what you are meditating. If people know you are meditating, it is your human nature that is doing it. So, when you are doing it, you are in an attitude of prayer. The Bible says, watch and pray. Is it when we face difficulty? Is it when we face difficulty? Is it when we are in trouble? When shall we wash and pray? All the time. But you are not pray all the time. You are not wash all the time. When you see something excited, very exciting thing, you stay your eyes, forgetting yourself. What I was expecting you to be meditating since morning, while you are here, you just sit down and say, let him speak out what I'm expecting you to say. Who is this man God? Who is this man God? Who is this prophet God? Who is this prophet God? Show me who is this man. Show me. Before you know it, you go in trance. The Lord will show you. Or whatever you are saying. What is this? What is it? I want to know more about the situation, where I am now, in the name of Jesus. Nobody will know what you are saying. You meditate. If you are doing that, you will not have time to engage in necessary discussion. You are not commit yourself with God's project. This is God's project. Tell your neighbor, this is God's project. There are man projects, there are God's project. But this is God's project you are engaging now. When you begin to do that, that doubt in your heart, that corruptible sea nature in your heart, your many heart is so corrupt. Many things cross their mind. Don't do that. Let's go and smoke. Some people are inside the church now. That spirit say, go out and smoke. They have urge of going to smoke. That kind of corruptive nature inside your heart will be cleansed by praying in the spirit. Try it. You will see your heart will be clean. You now become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. The righteousness is a gift of God. This, it can happen. Start it. When you are inside a place and you see the situation, already you are in the spirit, you are praying. What the Bible mean by being spirit? Mean prayer in the spirit. That is what the Bible means. How can one be in spirit? Is it possible for you to transform yourself? Say, how can I be in spirit now? They say, I should be in spirit. How will I be in spirit? No, they are saying, you have two natures. Your divine nature should be praying. As you are here, inside you. Before you know, you will be working like this, you will be seeing vision. God wants you to act with him. He wants you to act with him and know God's opinion and know people's opinion about you and others. God wants you to know this. It's a gift of God. Every man must act with God, must plan with God, must think with God. That is the reason why we are designed. Mankind is designed. Say after me, mankind is designed to act with God, to plan with God, and to think with Him. Are you acting with God? Do you act with God? Are you planning with God? When you cannot see vision, you cannot see anything beyond your nose, you cannot see. Because your divine nature is dormant. So when you start this now, little opportunity you have now, whether you sleep, where inside the church, whether you sleep or not, you'll be eating, you'll be seeing vision. You'll be eating, you'll see, you dream. You walk, you'll be dream. You'll be seeing vision. Inside the vehicle, you move inside the vehicle or train, even inside the plane, it's possible inside the vehicle you tell the driver, please wait. Please, I want to get down. You must have seen people like that. They will stop the driver and say, please, wait, I want to get down here. He has seen something. In that vehicle, he has seen something about to happen. You want to catch your flight, you sit down at the airport, waiting for flight. Because your spiritual man, your divine nature is busy praying. You are in the spirit. There, the Lord will show you where you are flying to. If there will be any mistake, you just go to the counter and say, please, I want to change my flight. I'm not going with this flight. You want to see the show, you tell people there, please, I advise you, this is the situation of things. That is what God created you for. That is the design of God. How can you enter trouble just like that? How can one be destroyed just like that? How can one, you don't know. Are you in the spirit? Let us see your hand if you are in the spirit. This is what the Bible means. Because we don't know the meaning of being in spirit. Being in spirit means let your spiritual man, that is your divine nature, be seen praying, meditating. All the purity, clean thing, continue to meditate it. That's all. There will be no room for corruptive nature. Unclean doubt in your heart will disappear. You dream, see vision. No God's opinion about yourself and about other. Even when you are eating, that does not, it's not you, it is not your human, divine nature that's eating. Your divine nature does not eat food. The word of God is the food of your divine nature. It is this flesh that eats amala, whatever you are eating. So if you are eating, that will not disturb you not to meditate in the spirit. You continue to meditate in the spirit. It is the same spirit, the divine nature, that will tell you whether the food is poison or is good for your body or not. You can take food like this, you are about to put it in your mouth, the divine nature will say, stop, drop it. It's poison. And you drop it. So we continue. Immediately we come back. I think I need to talk more about this. The visitor. Viewers all over the world, please, this is God's plan for you. Your divine nature has been dormant for many years now. This is as a result of this, you face crisis, nightmare. You don't know God's opinion. You cannot act with God. There is no way you can act with God. When you continue to pray, when your human nature continues to pray, the prayer you offer all the time is human. And when your human nature pray, you are saying where, not praying prayer. Human nature saying where. Divine nature praying prayer. Tell your neighbor.
again. Again. Human nature saying words. Watch your screen. Watch your screen. So the work of human nature will talk. Hey, how are you? Where you come from? A long time. Happy New Year. Long time. How are you? Yes. Yes, I will travel next time. Okay. It is here, yes. That is human nature. But when it is time to pray, to loose and to burn, and to fight this principality, human nature, praying prayer. But the same way, how will you know is your human or divine? You know when you begin to break the yoke. Human cannot break the yoke. You only saying, I the book in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Amen, and will say good word. Prayer point. Say, in Jesus' name, amen. You sweat. The human nature can preach well, can pray without left power, can preach without left power, can teach without rare power, but divine nature will preach with real power. So thank you. Let's give thanks to God and then move to another session. If you are blessed, let us see your hand. And you know with this, sky will be your limit, let us see your hand. With this, with the key you have today, unless you drop this assignment, like I'm talking to you now, you must be also pray in the spirit. So wave your hand, wave your hand, wave your hand, and give thanks to God. If you continue this life, oh, another chance has come. Right now, your prayer request, wave it, wave your prayer request. Wave your prayer request and your thanksgiving.
Levez-vous en tête de prière.
Oh,
we worship you.